CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.8, given a scenario, install, configure and secure a basic wireless network. Wireless network best practices. Whether you are setting up and configuring an access point, a wireless router, or a SOHO router, there are common tasks that should be performed to maintain the security of your wireless network. And this list can be extensive. But CompTIA's exam objective 2.8 has us focusing on two particular configuration best practices. They are changing the SSID and changing the device's default administrative password. I will assume for a moment that you are unfamiliar with the term SSID and will therefore explain what it is. The term SSID stands for Service Set Identifier. The SSID is a unique alphanumeric identifier given to a wireless local area network. The SSID serves as the name or label for the network, allowing devices like computers, smartphones, and other Wi-Fi-enabled devices to recognize and connect to it. The SSID is essential because it helps devices identify and connect to the correct wireless network. When you want to join a Wi-Fi network, you select its SSID from a list, like the one behind me. Look familiar? Now that you know what an SSID is, why should you change it when setting up and configuring a new wireless network device? Changing the SSID when first configuring a wireless device is a security best practice that is designed to enhance the overall security of your network. Most routers come with default SSIDs set by the manufacturer. These default names are often well known and can be easily identified. Malicious actors or the bad guys might use this information to specifically target networks with default settings for potential attacks. In addition to changing the default SSID, you should also change the default administrative password on the wireless network device. This password serves as the device's login credentials and is used to access and configure the device's settings and features. Again, just like the default SSID, default admin passwords are often well known and can be easily exploited by malicious actors or the bad guys, if not changed right away. So to recap, when configuring a new wireless network device, it is best practice to change the default SSID and the default admin password as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.